Kingsbury House, Wiltshire, September 1st, 1939. My dear Sam, your letter arrived yesterday morning, when there was still a faint hope that Europe wouldn't be what it is today. Anyhow, it was lovely to hear from you. And I spent the afternoon of my repetition of August 4, 1914, pushing George round the wood in his pram, and praising God for his mind-absolving presence. Once or twice, I lapsed into a muttered comment on the behavior of von Ribbentrop and his unholy master. And George only remarked, "What was that you said, Father?" To which I replied that if we went a bit further, we should probably see a simply enormous spider. And sure enough, we did. I also praised God for allowing George to be too young to understand what September 1, 1939 means. If anyone had told me 7 years ago that I should be able to be at all happy on the day when England and Germany would be at war again, I should have said that such a thing was impossible. But George is my armor against almost everything unpleasant. And I am resolved to make the best of this war, bad though it is. Bad. Is it bad if it results in the extermination of Hitler and his method of governing Germany? I don't think so, nor do you. You told me yourself, as we walked in the Rose Garden, that you would give your life to rid the world of that horror. Let us pray that public opinion in the United States will agree with you. I have been wondering how I can make myself useful. And I have thought that more unlikely things might happen than the spectacle of SS returning to the States as a propagandist of the struggle to defeat Hitler. Now look here, Mr. President, I should remark. What about it? And he would reply, Mr. Sassoon, I will do my utmost to carry your wishes into effect. I should then go out and have lunch with you at the Plaza Hotel and present you with a piece of its plate as of yore. Do you remember that handsome cabman's face when I offered him the silver in payment of his fare? I think I must have been a little mad in those days. Or was I merely young? Slow in making up their minds. But they have never been more united than they are at this moment. Are saying and thinking, bankers and all. sinister is in a ferment of preparations for 20 refugees from London. We are told that they may be expectant mothers.